Good evening, vlog readers. It is tilapia night at our house, and we are doing one of our favorite cooking methods, which is parchment paper packages. You've probably seen these on Food Network before or heard about them, but it's a really fun way to have kind of a one-dish meal that there's not much to clean up, and it's pretty fun too. So we're using a roll of parchment paper. I think I bought this at World Market, but you could probably find it at your grocery store as well. And pulled off a big long sheet of it and folded it in half, and we're gonna assemble the thing here and then fold it over and staple it together. So first we have a bunch of loose spinach. I've already made one of these in advance, so this is the second half. So you could use baby spinach for this, which would make your life easier. You wouldn't have to wash the greens or anything. But the bunch spinach is a lot cheaper than the baby spinach, so if it's for something like this that you just need to wilt it, then I would recommend using this. Second, we have some bok choy, baby bok choy, which is green. It's kind of like a mixture between celery and lettuce. It's got like the kind of the crunchy ends and then the leaves at the top. So dump that on as well. And you want to kind of keep things away from the edges if you can. Then we have three kinds of julienne vegetables. We have celery, chopped right here, and some carrot. And this is a lot of vegetables, but it'll taste good, and if we have leftovers, we'll have leftovers. So those are the vegetables, and lastly we have red bell pepper. Then I am going to pour on just a little bit of this homemade sauce that we have. It is made from honey mustard, a little bit of cider vinegar, a little lemon juice, and a little bit of honey. And it's just going to kind of act as a little binder in here. I'm going to pour just a tiny bit on the vegetables and save the rest for the fish. This is frozen tilapia that we thaw overnight the night before we're going to make a fish meal. Already seasoned with salt and pepper. And we're going to lay that guy on. And lastly, top with a couple lemons. I would also recommend using dill on this, which I love on fish. But unfortunately, we're out of dill and we keep forgetting to buy it. And just top it off with a little bit more of the honey mustard sauce. We have preheated the oven to 350 degrees. So you want to obviously do that first. And this part can be a little difficult, but the bigger your paper, the easier it will be. You want to make sure you get a pretty good seal here. Just kind of fold it up like a big taco, like that on the edges. And I actually cheat and use a stapler to hold it together because, I don't know, if you have something that staples, why not use it? So, definitely helps with the process if you can just kind of move along like that. Don't worry if you staple through spinach or something, that's fine. I don't know if they make organic staples out there, but you could research that. And since this is basically going to steam in this nice paper package, you want to make sure you get it pretty tightly sealed all around, especially your edges. Like that. So now we have our two packets. It looks like this one's a little bit bigger, so I guess it didn't do a great job making them even. But I'm gonna put this in the oven probably about 15 to 20 minutes. You wanna make sure your fish is done. If you're using a thicker fish, you wanna make sure you do it a little bit longer. But the tilapia probably only needs like 10 minutes because it's not really that thick of a fish. So pop that in and we will set the timer. It's been 18 minutes and we're ready to take it out. So first I'm gonna turn the oven off. And one thing, if you get done, you know, your vegetables can be done, but if your fish for some reason is not done, pop it in the microwave and finish it off. Or you could stick it back in the oven. But it's probably pretty hot in here, but gonna give it a nice cut open. You can eat it out of the packet, or you can, put it in a nice bowl, which is what we're going to do. But I hope you can see, man, this smells amazing. The honey mustard sauce And you can see how much smaller it's gotten now that all the greens have wilted. So I'm probably going to transfer this to the bowl off camera because it's rather messy, and we'll get back to you when it's all set and pretty in the bowl. Oh, excuse me, I was just photographing my food. Last but not least, I gotta take a bite. I topped it with a little avocado, squirted some of the lemon juice on, and then a little red pepper flakes also. So you can see there's just all these different layers of flavors. There's a nice juice on the bottom, and I'm gonna get a little bit of the fish.